A year ago right now, a KCCI viewer told me that she saw the same thing every morning here along this stretch of University Avenue and had a hunch there might be a story worth sharing. I'm so honored she took the time to let me know because it led up to this story, a year in the making.
February mornings can be brutal, especially when the wind's whipping and everything is white, everything except that Cadillac and its bundled up driver.
Good morning.
Pat Steinbach, whose watch reads 11 o'clock.
Let me go get my book and I'll be right back, okay?
Meaning it's time for him to read.
Ow.
See what they're doing.
John Grisham.
The guy's name was Daryl Sackett.
This morning might be three below.
Her first, whoa. Fingers getting a little cold again.
But that's nothing for this dad.
We miss you, Matthew. We miss you a lot. Another month, it's gonna be 1 year. Hard to believe. Hard to believe.
Because 11 months ago, his boy died.
And it was a kick.
So after Matthew's funeral,
I just kind of snuck out of the house and drove over here. And you know, they had the flowers and everything here, and I just laid on top of him. And I just, you know, said that I won't let you be forgotten, Matthew.
The very next day, he brought a chair, a book, and a pop.
Well, I suppose. The pop's getting frozen. That's usually the time to leave, isn't it?
And stayed for an hour. Just like he did the day after that. Some days have been bright. Some have had snow.
I try to get out here every day to see him.
And some, by May.
It mowed yesterday.
And bright green buds.
I just want to clean it up a little.
Signaling it was time for a trim.
Now I get to look pretty.
Because before Pat sits down to read every day.
Morning, son.
His dad is a dad.
Wow, it's June 3rd already. It's flying by, son. Flying by.
And some days have been tougher than others.
I can still picture him when he was little, you know, 8, 9, 10 years old. You know, happy Father's Day and just his smile.
The toughest are birthdays, anniversaries, and yes, Father's Day.
It's more challenging. It's a lot more challenging.
But he says this time, with a book and his son's gravestone.
There were so many calls to be made.
Has. Helped, because at first
we struggled with the fact of even saying it.
That Matthew died of an accidental heroin overdose. Now, 15 months later, Pat can talk about it with people.
You know, they know that there's a problem, and it's unfortunate that our son got caught in that problem of drugs.
And they've noticed his daily devotion.
I always think of him. I mean, I can tell you all day long I think of him. People honk and wave all the time.
Minus 20 mornings are gone.
It's a lot nicer now. It is a lot nicer.
But summer's green only lasts so long too, because by October, Glendale's leaves,
they're changing,
mirror this dad's emotions.
This time of year's difficult. Things are dying, plants are dying, and things are changing. And it makes me think a lot about him in that way.
After four seasons, Pat knows what you might be thinking.
What I do is probably crazy to a lot of people. They probably think I'm nuts. I'm not. I loved my son, and this is what I want to do.
And an hour every day at his son's tombstone is what works for him.
I still have those waves. I still have them. Not as often.
So just like he did surrounded by winter's snow, spring's flowers, and summer's heat, his devotion continued.
I haven't missed any days because of weather.
Until winter returned. Because this December, you won't find a folding chair, an orange can, or Pat. Just a handwritten note. Hi, Matthew, it reads. My aortic valve is bad. Even though I won't be here with you every day, I will always be thinking about you. Pat Steinbach spent all year in Glendale Cemetery healing his broken heart until his heart landed him in the hospital. I'll be back in a few weeks, he wrote, ending his note with a sentiment that was so clear all year. I love and miss you forever, Dad.